Good morning, my darlings. Welcome to a new vlog. This hair bubble looks as though it's very much part of my outfit today. Today is, as per usual, a working from home day, and it's a Monday. I actually took the weekend off vlogging. Charlie's parents came over, so it was just a very nice, relaxing weekend. We had an amazing roast yesterday, and it was the most perfect autumn day, so we went for a gorgeous long walk as well. Today is going to be a very busy working from home day. We are doing some shooting tomorrow, and I would like to get super duper organized so that the shoot is really smooth. We're doing a lot of Christmas content, so I'm really hoping that my second Christmas tree will be arriving today. I ordered one, you may remember from the previous vlogs, last week, but I didn't even think about the size. I just automatically thought, oh, I need a really big one. And it was so big. It was a 12 footer, and the base of it was like the size of this entire area. It was just ginormous. And obviously height wise, it just did not fit in the room. So I've ordered, I think, a 7.5 footer, which I'm hoping will be the correct size. Just had to run downstairs because our Burlington bathroom bits have just arrived. All of these pieces, I'm so excited to get that bathroom done, but it still needs wallpapering first. Quick outfit of the day. I don't know why, in this mirror I always look so shiny. As you can see, I'm having a very casual hair day today. I've just put some Living Proof dry shampoo in and it's looking a little bit more salvageable. I've got this gorgeous chunky knit on from Holland Cooper. It's got the lovely detail on the shoulders and on the sleeves. It's just so, so warm and cozy. I have to say, where's the temperature? Yeah, this house is pretty warm. We've got the underfloor heating on, not on a particularly high setting, and it's 22 degrees in most of the rooms, but I like to be super cozy at all times. So I've got the lovely chunky jumper on, and then these are actually brown leggings from Sweaty Betty, and my little emu slippers, because we've got so many hard floors, I'm literally always wearing slippers. So yeah, hopefully the second Christmas tree will arrive today. We can get that set up for the photos, and I'm thinking I might actually go to Burford Garden Centre later on today. It's a really nice day. I think maybe around 4 o'clock. I'm gonna see what time it shuts when I've done loads of work for the day, because we're definitely gonna have to get some more Christmas props. And obviously, yes, they are initially gonna be used for props, but it will be fabulous to have lots of new decorations for the house. And I might even go up into our loft later and do a little stock take of the decorations that we already have as well. Have you found the best spot in the house, my little chicken nugget and chips? Oh, mummy, don't disturb me, please. Oh, the camera's out. I must join you because I'm always the star of the show. Okay, everybody, remember how scruffy we look right now? Because we are just about to go and get our hair cut, and how are we feeling about it, Dexie?
I love getting my hair cut, if I'm honest, but my brother doesn't.
No. I like to look as fancy as possible. Show everybody how long your ear hair
is.
I'll
be having a manicure, you see.
A manicure, a pedicure, not a pedicure, a pedicure. Oh. I'll be getting my ears trimmed. Yes, I can't wait. Me, on the other hand, I love to look as scruffy as possible.
Dickie still looks scruffy even when he comes
back. I do, but I can't wait to get my bottom tidied up in particular. Anyway, come on, Mummy and Daddy, we're going to be late for our appointment. Oh, goodness me. Welcome back to the messy room. Oh my goodness. This is our loft, and as you can see, it is full and very messy indeed. So I'm now going to have a rummage and see if I can find any Christmas decorations and any wrapping paper. It is going to be a challenge. Goodness me, you would think it is December in this room. We have been scurrying around looking for little boxes, empty boxes to wrap up as faux Christmas gifts. These are going to be props underneath my Christmas tree when that finally arrives. This is all Christmas paper that I had spare from last year, so these will look great piled up underneath the tree. I also just took delivery of an H&M order, so I thought I would just go through some of these pieces with you. I must have placed this order about 2 weeks ago. It took so long to arrive, so I've got no idea if any of this stuff will still be in stock, but I'll show you anyway. So I really wanted these for my autumn tablescape, and to be honest, having had Charlie's parents here last weekend, and I don't think we've got any visitors next weekend, I'm not sure if anyone will get to see another autumn tablescape, but I really like these jars, and apparently they're all recycled glass, quite rough shapes, and I just thought these would look lovely with some dried foliage from the gardens. I thought for a Christmas tablescape, this was quite cute. I might bake some muffins or cupcakes later to pop on there. I wanted quite a rustic tablecloth, so I think this one will be really nice in this kind of sagey linen. And then, are these tea towels? Yes, some really nice, again, quite sagey green tea towels. I think will be a lovely addition. And just getting ready for Christmas, I saw this table runner with the festive looking berries. So lots of nice new linen for the table. And then these I thought were rather pretty. I have been doing some slightly more natural kind of string and rosemary style presentation for the napkins, but I thought these would be quite nice for Christmas. They have got little, gosh, camera's not enjoying it, little pearls on them, and I think that looks like a mistletoe twig. So I got loads of those. Haha, this is the best thing from the H&M order. A little Christmas jumper. It appears I've only ordered one though. And I have two doggies, so I'm gonna have to order another one. But yeah, this is a really, really cute little Christmas jumper for my little boys who are currently getting pruned. And then some other bits and bobs, which I can't even remember because it was so... Ah, this is amazing. So do you remember the Isabel Maron jumper that I showed you in a vlog a couple of weeks ago? Well, let me tell you, it looked exactly like this, like literally exactly the same with this shoulder detail. That one was just on loan from Net-a-Porter. So as soon as I saw this, I was like, yes, oh my goodness, get into my wardrobe. So that's a great little dupe if you loved the Isabel Maron jumper. And what's this? A chunky knit? Oh, it looks like a cropped knit. Yeah, just another, I don't know if I need both of these. I'll try them on, see which one it looks best. And then if you remember this picture, I'll pop it up on the screen here. I love this dress, but lots of you asked me to try and find a dupe. And this one, I'll put the picture on the screen here of this on the H&M website, looks really, really similar. I do love an autumnal floral pattern. And this one, it looks gorgeous. And then one of you guys actually messaged me about this. I've been looking for a really, really comfy padded coat to wear at this time of year, just when I'm out in the garden, walking the dogs, that kind of thing. So this is absolutely perfect. So that's my H&M order that I've waited about 10 million years for, and I think it is worth the wait. Hello, it is Josie from the future here, interjecting to show you how the dress looks on colour-wise. I absolutely love it. It has got a slip inside, which is great. I'm wearing a bright white bra and I need to shorten the straps on the slip, but the silhouette is absolutely lovely. I think this could look even nicer with a waist belt, so I'm going to try that look as well. Honestly, this belt just makes everything look so much better. I have cinched it in around the waist with, of course, my Gucci belt, and it just creates a lot more of a flattering silhouette. The skirt has got this kind of tiered structure going on. Yes, this is an absolute winner from H&M. I actually cannot believe how similar this jumper looks to the Isabel Maron. It is all in the shoulder detail. It's got the same kind of tuck style detail. The fabric honestly looks so expensive. It's got slightly chunkier sleeves, and maybe it's a little bit longer, but I've just folded this up to give it that cropped silhouette. Thankfully, it is not itchy, but I would most likely wear a thermal underneath this, because sometimes these kind of jumpers can get itchy the longer you wear them, the more you kind of breathe in it. But yeah, this is such a great dupe. And even if you don't care that it's an Isabel Maron dupe, it's just a really, really lovely jumper with a very subtle design detail here on the shoulders. And you can see on the arms, it's a really nice kind of cable knit as well, but then really lovely and simple on the front. I think out of the two, I definitely prefer the other jumper. This one feels a little bit, I don't know, something a bit school-like about this neckline, and I just don't feel like I need them both, so I'm going to send this one back. But this is potentially more up some people's street. Just I prefer the other one, so I feel like it's a bit excessive to keep both. It's slightly more cropped on the sleeves, which I actually really like, and then it's more fitted around this waistband here. I do like this collar, but I have to say I prefer my Reese jumper, which is similar to this, which has a similar collar and a little zip, so I just don't need two quite so similar in my wardrobe.
I know that you're curious, I know that you're strong, but life can be furious.
I have just unboxed this epic pair of walking boots that were so kindly sent to me from Sorrel Footwear, and they are just so amazing. This kind of chunky blush pink walking boots. They've got, excuse my socks, I've got those socks that stop themselves from sliding down. They're really good when you're like wearing in shoes and then you don't get blisters. Yeah, really beautiful, almost like rose blush pink shade. Very chunky soles, they'll be great for walking. And this really gorgeous, very light pink padded section. They really are so beautifully made. I think we're gonna head to Burford Garden Centre now, so I thought I would wear these for the expedition. So a very comfy, casual outfit of the day. Still, oh, I look like I have an actual rabbit's tail on my head. But first we're gonna go and pick up our little boys who have had their pruning and pampering.
Stay true to that fire in your heart and your soul. Don't drench your desire in what you can't control. We fly, try so hard to get there, and we might be lost, but not forever.
Well, I've got two very traumatized looking doggies in the back of the car. Are you looking very smart though, Deg Deg? Mommy, I'm really not happy about it. I look like a fool. Chicky's fast asleep. His dapple is a lot more vivid when he's been groomed. Now, Mommy's off to the garden center. Wow, look at this nutcracker.
You're not even close.
Oh my goodness.
Don't wish for indifference. You're not one of those. We fall, but we always rise up through it all, we get a little wiser. There's things in life you simply need to know, but sun and rain and trust in letting go. It takes a bit of suffering, sleepless nights and wandering, before you make it safely to the end, the end, the end. And if you ever wonder, there is nothing wrong with a little
actually very peaceful because it's only 20 minutes until closing time, so we are pretty much the only people here, which is great. I am gonna get a fake Christmas tree just in case the one that I've ordered online doesn't arrive. I think I'm gonna go for this one. Looks rather lovely. The baubles here are absolutely amazing. Baubles are so expensive, but I'm gonna pick up a few really beautiful ones because they will last forever. I love these little nutcrackers. So cute. Leave me a comment down below with how you do your Christmas tree. Do you stick to a colour scheme? Do you get really unique decorations every single year? Or do you just go totally wild? I think we're gonna stick to a mainly gold scheme, but then possibly add a little bit of red in there for a bit of variation. I've decided I am gonna get the massive nutcracker. I feel like we have a private shopping experience. I would definitely recommend coming here at 5 o'clock on a Monday. Last time Charlie and I came, it was just totally rammed here. And social distancing was quite a challenge. This is gorgeous. I would love to get something like this in our drawing room. Wow. Something like this in the corner. My gosh, that is so lovely.
And we are back home again. That was a very successful mission. Oh my goodness, yes. Very successful mission. I don't know if I have the energy to unbox everything right now. You look so funny with your haircut, little boy. Dexter is still outside catching up on all the smells in his garden. Yeah, I don't know if I have the energy to unbox everything now. It's only 6:30, but because here in the UK the clocks have gone back, it gets dark an hour earlier, so it's been dark for at least a couple of hours, like pitch black. Don't know if you saw the clips, the sunset as we were driving to Burford was stunning. So yeah, because of that, it just makes me feel super, super tired. But I think I'm gonna make myself a mac and cheese because that always makes me feel better. And Mondays, Charlie has his sports massage. I'm also a little bit stressed from a work thing. Something I shouldn't be getting stressed about. Don't know if it's right to really share my conundrum, but whenever I do talk about worky things, you guys are like, oh, there's so much more to it than we thought originally, and you seem to really enjoy worky things. Basically, I'm just having a bit of a battle with a brand. Hello, my pumpkin. You smell funny when you've been to the groomers, you do, but you're so lovely. Yeah, basically trying to have a civil conversation with a brand. They're being quite blunt in their emails, and every time I ask a question about the brief, they are threatening to cancel the whole collaboration, and all I want to do is ask questions to make sure I do the job properly and not have to refilm anything, because yeah, I like to do a good job first time round and not have to reshoot anything. So I'd rather ask questions before doing the job, but they're not being very friendly when I ask questions, which is a bit of a pain. That's Dexy scratching at the door, and then I think we should put the kettle on and make a mac and cheese. So this is my Burford Garden Centre Christmas haul. There is a lot of stuff in here, including my little nutcracker, or my very big nutcracker actually. Yeah, this is a 4.5-foot tree, so it's not going to be massive, but potentially this will be a great one for the family room, or I don't know, it probably won't live in here. I think the one that I've ordered from Balsam Hill, I always think, is it Balsam or Balsam? But hopefully the one that I've ordered from Balsam Hill, which is I think a 7.5 or 8 foot, should have arrived today, but it didn't, very annoying, will live here eventually. But for the sake of tomorrow's photo shoot, I am going to get this one set up in this corner. It'll be just my luck. I will be putting the last bauble on this tree, and then UPS will turn up with my bigger tree. But anyway, while my mac and cheese is in the oven, I think I've probably got about 5 minutes until it's the perfect crispy golden gooiness on top. So I'm going to quickly unbox as much of this as possible and show you what beautiful pieces I have purchased for Christmas. Okay, so this is my favorite purchase. I've started with my favorite, which is probably not the best thing to do. Introducing, what should we call him? Norman, Norman the Nutcracker. He's got gorgeous white hair. I've actually got hair envy, and a white beard, which he can, oh, that's his mouth opening. That is kind of weird. He's got his little staff here. I actually got, what did we decide his name was? Norman? I actually got Norman £25 off. He was quite expensive, but I got him £25 off because he's got a bit of a dodgy leg, but I don't think anyone will notice that. My battery's flashing. There we go, fresh battery. And round in the post messy area where I keep my camera charger, I would have forgotten to show you this. So I actually did a Selfridges order as well. I just ordered this and a couple of bits that I'm gonna include in my Christmas gift guide. I just heard a really weird noise. This is actually the first time I've been alone in this house in the dark before, I think.
Anyway, I've got you guys for company. So I'm gonna call this little one Nancy. Nancy and Norman, the Nutcrackers. Nancy is very bougie. She's got jewelry on. I mean, she's definitely a guy, but So these are my lovely Nutcrackers, and I just think they're such a lovely Christmas decoration. Alrighty, and here we have got, so these are really lovely string lights, and they actually all cluster together at the top and then they fan down like a waterfall. And I think if you just place them and like spread them out over a Christmas tree, they look beautiful. What I'm gonna do, because I realize that probably 99.9% of you don't live anywhere near Burford Garden Center, I'm gonna do my very best to find all of these pieces on the World Wide Web. To be honest, probably a lot of them are available at a fraction of the price that I just paid on Amazon. But I'll try and link everything down below, because you'll probably see me decorating the tree and this and be like, oh, I really want one. So I will try and find everything. But yeah, that's not the only lighting that I purchased. A Christmas tree base, just a really simple one, nothing too jazzy, or it's called a skirt. If it helps you find these things online, this is from a company called Ivy Line. 100% sustainable material, ethically sourced, handcrafted in Indonesia. So that is my tree skirt. And then these are some jokey gifts for people that I know won't be watching this video. So Charlie's granddad, Dada, we always have the same joke that the chair that he sits on Christmas Day is the washing up chair. So he has to do the washing up. It's a joke because I have never seen Dada turn the tap on, let alone do any washing up, bless him. And we also always tease him about sprouts. So I got him a sprout washing up sponge, just a silly little stocking filler. And then Charlie and I bicker a lot about his excessive toilet roll usage. Definitely too much information. But I picked him up a dog printed toilet roll, which is totally ridiculous. But there we go. I was very much shopping under pressure. Okay. So I really wanted some things that I could create some beautiful tablescapes with. This is just the most gorgeous, like sparkly tabletop Christmas tree from Gisella Graham. And that's a brand that I see so many lovely Christmas decorations from. I would very much like to collaborate with Gisella Graham and do a really bougie Christmas decoration with her. Is this another set of lights? Okay, maybe the set that I showed you earlier wasn't that tree set, because this looks like that tree waterfall. Either way, we'll have a play with those tomorrow. And then they had these on display. They're actually, it's like a string of lights, but with these beautiful snowflakes. They don't look like anything when they're not lit up and like spread out, but they looked so gorgeous on the display. I think a lot of these are just gonna be baubles, which is gonna take quite a long time for me to undo them all. But just to show you the quality, again, this is Gisella Graham. There's one really beautiful one, like copper and gold. I must have bought about 20 baubles, so I'm only gonna open the ones in this bag, and then I'll show you the rest when I'm putting them on the tree. That might be tomorrow's vlog. It definitely won't be in this one. This is from a different brand, handpicked by Burford Garden Company, they call themselves. This is really delicate, beautiful glass. I bet that's hand dotted, hand decorated. Stunning. Charlie and I like to just get really beautiful decorations every year and just build it up to a beautiful treescape instead of having a particular theme. This one is another of the hand-picked ones that is just stunning. Ooh, he's going off on that one. Oh, I've already shown you one like this, but another one like that. Okay, there's some more crazy things in here. I got this giant sparkly moon. Don't ask me why, I just thought it was really effective. Kind of like a Christmas disco ball. It's one of those things that gets glitter everywhere. We have lots of pheasants around here in the Cotswolds, so I thought I would get a festive pheasant. Don't worry, it's not a real stuffed pheasant. It is actually really pretty. again from Gisella Graham. It's almost got like antique fabric around it, so I thought that was rather lovely. And then I'm pretty sure the rest of the things in here are Christmas tree decorations. They're just the most beautiful shape. So, so gorgeous. Gonna have to be so careful putting them on the tree. There's way more baubles in that bag. And then the only other thing is, of course, my tree. So as I mentioned, this is, I think, 4.5 foot, which is probably, I mean, it's taller than what it is in the box. So yeah, it should be a good size anyway. That's my lovely collection of goodies. Now, let's go and check on my macaroni cheese. I am very sorry, darlings. I did not show you my mac and cheese. I just got it out the oven and tucked straight in like a little porker. And it was delicious. I actually thought to myself, I'm going to make a small one this evening because I'm not ravenous. And then I ended up making an absolutely massive one. So my portion control was not good this evening. So I just thought I would come upstairs and sign off. I've got back into using my face halo lately. I've got three of these. I've got a red one, a white one, and a black one. I would say the darker colours are a bit better because my white one, even though I put it through the wash every time I use it, is quite stained, whereas my red one and my black one are not. I forgot how much I loved these. I went through a phase of using them last year, and then I think maybe it was actually when we moved house, I just had them in a different box and I got out the habit of using them. But I've started using them again as my first cleanse. To be honest, they are so thorough that actually, if I was having a light makeup day, I'd say they'd probably be enough. But I still do my micellar water and then my double cleanse after this. Or if I'm really lazy, I will just do my micellar water after this. And I have to say, I'm always really surprised with how little makeup comes off on the cotton pad, or on the reusable cotton pad, I should say, after I've done this. And because I have been using more expensive micellar waters, like that gorgeous By Terry one, it is saving a lot of micellar water, because to get my skin to this amount of cleanliness, I probably would have gone through at least like 6 to 8 pumps of micellar water. And it also takes off eye makeup, but I do often go back in with my Lizelle eye makeup remover, the eye soothing, I think it's called the Eye Bright. But this is a fantastic first cleanse. I have so many micellar waters on the go at the moment because I just finished a By Terry. I picked up a Garnier in my Sainsbury's order, but straight after my By Terry ran out, I switched over to the Elemis cleansing micellar water. So I'm gonna pop some of this onto my reusable cotton pad and let's see how clean this cotton pad is, considering I've just used a face halo. And bearing in mind, if I did this on a fresh face of makeup, this would be completely covered. Wow. That is all that is on my face at the moment after using the face halo. And some of you may think that that's a lot, but actually for me, that is not a lot. So that is pretty darn impressive. So as I said, I have got three face halos. I don't use them in the mornings actually, because I feel like I don't have any makeup on and I just want to get rid of the oils on my skin. And I feel like a micellar water is good at the oils part a bit better than the face halo. I'm sure it would be good as well. So basically I have three of these in rotation. I wash them in the washing machine in my little zippy bag with my reusable cotton pads. So I'm using a clean one every day. And obviously we're doing washes more than once every 3 days. So I always seem to have a clean one. Taking a fresh cotton pad and the Lizelle Eye Bright. This is great at very, very gently removing your eye makeup. And if I forget this stage, then I do often feel like I have a bit of mascara left. But once again, I mean, wow. So all I did was swipe over with the face halo, and that is how much is left. So it really does get rid of your eye makeup as well, and I don't know how it works, it is actual sorcery. And then I will just choose my cleanser. At the moment, I'm just switching between a few that I've got lying around, like my Lizelle Cleanse and Polish, Elemis AHA Pumpkin Enzyme. I've got some Yves Lom capsules with the oil in, which are really, really lovely. This is the adorable little capsule of the Yves Lom cleansing oil. You get quite a lot of oil in these little capsules, so it gives you a really, really good cleanse. And when I'm using an oil cleanser like this, I tend to give myself a really nice facial massage as well. But darlings, that is all from today's... Oh, got a little spot down there. That is all for today's vlog. I really hope you enjoyed coming Christmas decoration shopping with me, and a few other updates. Don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I'll see you soon in the next one.